Hi everyone! If you are a student, you have to memorize huge amounts of information in the course of your studies. In particular, people of medical and technical specialties have to keep in mind a lot of material. During my studies, I had an opportunity to experience that feeling of being overwhelmed myself. And in this video, I want to share with you this experience and give you a few tips how to remember a lot of information. Here we go! And the first thing I would like to emphasize is mnemotechniques. Each of us remembers information in his own way. Some have a fairly well-developed visual memory, some have an emotional one. It can be a funny association, for example, an unusual name of a conjunction or element that you came up with yourself, or a good joke that you heard while memorizing information. A good example from my life. When our teacher was explaining to us the structure of the atom, there was a parallel to the apartments in Moscow. The farther from the center, the worse the quality of housing. Similarly with the atom, the farther an electron is from the nucleus, the easier it is to take it away. So for remembering information, associations that are related to what you have encountered before are excellent. As an example, let's take the situation of determining the configuration of the organic compound. Take the lactic acid molecule. In these and other cases, you should mentally draw an arrow from the senior to the junior substituent. If in this case the seniority decreases clockwise, it is R isomer. In the reverse situation, the S isomer. So associative methods are very helpful. Also, visualize for yourself what you are studying. For example, you study the colors of different compounds. What you can do here, you can highlight the formulas of these compounds in your notes with corresponding colors. Believe me, it will make your life significantly easier if you simply start visualizing things. Before you take this advice, you should decide what helps you to remember a lot of facts. If you need to memorize something very voluminous or something that is connected, make tables and charts. Even if you are not a born artist, create such things for yourself. It's the essence, not the appearance, that counts, unless you are going to start a business selling your notes later. So you save space in your notes and be able to highlight only the main thing from the webinars and lectures to structure the information. This will help you remember the material better, especially people with a good visual memory, because there will be no unnecessary information that will be later unnecessary. Save time when fixing the information and quickly repeat it if necessary. We subconsciously perceive the tablet as an essence and try to enter only the most important things in it. With the help of charts, I managed to pass a whole bunch of exams successfully because with the help of tables and diagrams, I was able to remember the necessary information. Another great example is the relationship of classes of organic compounds to each other. With charts like this, you can structure the information and repeat it fairly quickly if necessary. And although this picture may look terrible at the first glance, trust me, without this worm, it would look much worse. And of course, you can draw such a diagram by hand. It shouldn't look perfect at all. The main thing is you can figure it out. The next piece of advice we would like to give you is solving problems as soon as you learn something. This is very important precisely in technical fields of activities. When you solve various problems, calculating or qualitative, it doesn't matter, you apply the acquired knowledge in practice. And it also allows you to better remember the information. I do it like this. I choose a topic that I don't know or that I barely know. Last time it was heterocycles. And first I study the theory in detail, structure, physical and chemical properties. Then I take my favorite problem books or college assignments. As a rule, you can find them on the university websites or from acquaintances. I solve all the problems on this topic based on my notes. In such cases, in the course of my work, I write down all my actions in detail. How you came up with the idea, what follows from it, etc. This helps to recognize strengths and weaknesses. More importantly, prescribing all my actions, I myself come to the idea that is the task. And therefore evolve. Another secret of success during your studies is don't rush to throw away all your old notes in the trash bin. Here again, my study experience has shown that these notes, especially from the first years of the university, can come in very handy. Notes, drafts with problems, essays, everything you have left over from your studies at different periods of life. With their help, you can not only repeat forgotten information and solve embarrassing situations, but also track your progress. And this matters in any case a lot. If you have ever dealt with scientific activity, you know very well that people of chemical specialties have to draw up a huge number of papers, abstracts, dissertations, articles. To make your work more presentable and neat, use visualization programs. One of the definitely best ones is ChemDraw. Our team is working much with this program to create visual structures for our videos. And actually, it's not an advertisement. ChemDraw will help you enough to depict the two-dimensional structure of your organic compound, while the other two programs, Avogadro and MolView, will be able to translate all the creations into three-dimensional space. There is enough information on YouTube or other forums about how to use these programs. You can find a link to one of such videos in the description. Moreover, our team is confident that anyone can master their functionality. The next item is, oddly enough, closely related to mathematics. Develop spatial thinking. When studying chemistry, this type of thinking is as important as a brush to the artist. Spatial thinking will help you better understand the structure of the molecule, its reactivity, and other features. Illustrations in books will also help you develop this type of thinking. Drawings of molecules in two- and three-dimensional space will help you understand the structure of substances, their relationships, and the resulting chemical reactions and processes. Of course, not everyone can imagine complex molecular structures in his or her head. Not everyone has a good spatial imagination. But that's where we can help. In our lectures, we try to show as clearly as possible, not just tell. And the final point for today has to do with both mnemotechniques and practice. Actively use the results of chemical experiments as you study the material. You can find them freely available on the internet. There are a lot of videos on YouTube that clearly show the outcome of a particular reaction, for example, the interaction of sodium and water. This way, you can deepen and strengthen your theoretical knowledge. Attend all kinds of events. For example, it can be open master classes where various experiments will be shown. Starting with spectacular ones such as Pharaoh, snake, volcano, and ending with those that will help in everyday life. For example, how to clean precious jewelry at home. Information about such events is posted either on chemical forums or in social networks as advertising. Other events you can attend include open door days at universities, career guidance classes, and presentations of individual fields of study. These all usually show something that might interest you specifically. Watch the career fair video and you'll see what we're talking about. I remember having a situation like this. Once people from the university came to our school to present several of their departments. Among them were the chemistry, physics, and geography departments. Besides communicating with the people who work there and asking questions, they also showed something that symbolized each faculty. So the faculty of physics showed a flying drone, which they collected themselves. From the geography department, there was a collection of minerals from different expeditions. The chemistry department did various spectacular experiments and talked about how it works. So find out from the university, school, social media forums, where, when, and how such events will take place. This way, you can not only see visually what you are going to study, but also to meet and talk to interesting people. Well, that's all the things we'd like to share with you so far for learning chemistry. Stay tuned, follow our forum, and learn lots of new and interesting things. See you in more videos and lectures. Bye!